Everything is given to everything. There is no lack anywhere. There is no lack anywhere. So it's really important in spiritual exercises in your life is to allow yourself everything to slow down for you. Simplify, very simple. When the batter goes up to the plate with all these thoughts in mind, what's he gonna throw? Okay, last time he threw me this, and then he went to that pitch, and this one, this sequence, and they're trying to guess sequence. That's too many thoughts in their head. They're late, they can't hit. You go up there with no thought at all, you know, just no thoughts. Hey, nice day today. Wow, beautiful day. I feel great. It's like the, look at the grass is so green, lovely. So you go up there that way. Sun is shining. Hey, how you doing? Great to be here. Yeah. Smiling, relaxed, everything's slow. Stretch a little bit. And say, wow, this is easy for me. Very easy. This is the key. This is the key. So that's why we're having this attitude, smiling, chuckling, laughing. This is easy. This is easy. Now we're also in this mood of repentance, which is we're not jittery. It means we're not jittery. We're serious. We're sober. We're still. We're non-reactive. We're non-argumentative. We're not up there trying to be ferocious. Okay, very humble. Very mood of repentance. Very humble, saying, I have a severe continuity problem, so I need to work on it. So we're here to work. In other words, it's a workmanlike attitude we have. We're here to work. It's business. We're here to work. We're craftsmen. We're doing our craft here, and we're serious about it. At the same time, we have a sense of ease about it. So this is easy. This is simple. I can do it. No problem. No problem. We're not struggling. We're not struggling. Don't struggle. Don't allow yourself to struggle. This is easy. Today is my born again, one and only true birthday. My born again birthday. Now everything is given to everything. Now I see everything is given to everything. Now I know everything is given to everything. There is no lack anywhere. Today is my one true born again birthday. Today is my one true birthday. Now I can give everything to everything. Now I see everything is given to everything. Now I give everything to everything. There is no lack anywhere. There is no lack anywhere. God's laws are equal everywhere. God's laws are equal everywhere. So don't try to guess what's coming. Whatever comes, I'm ready. Whatever comes is ready because I have this simple exercise. I know today is my one true birthday. Now I can give everything to everything. Now I see everything is given to everything. Now I give everything to everything. Thus, there is no lack anywhere. Now I see there is no lack anywhere. Now I know there is no lack anywhere. God's laws apply equally everywhere. God's laws are equally applied everywhere. So you don't get these hitters, they're getting called out on third strikes because they're looking for some pitch and they're looking for an outside curveball and they throw an inside cutter, strike three called, and they're like all freaked out and get angry and arguing with the umpire. No way, you know, because they weren't looking for it. You see, they were looking for a certain place, location, everything, and so they got fooled. You can't do that way. And so you get all argumentative, all right? So the mood is we have here is non-argumentative, non-debating, non-argumentative. We're not trying to guess. We're not guessing here. We're not guessing. We say, hey, it doesn't matter what you got, pitcher. I know what I got. I know what I got. So that's, and I know it's good enough. I know it's good enough. Okay? That's the attitude. We have the Holy Spirit. All right? The Holy Spirit is good enough. All right? We know what we got. We have the Holy Spirit. So what do we need to worry? I don't care what the pitcher's throwing. I'm gonna have fun up here. I'm having fun at the plate. This is fun. I'm happy to be here. I'm not all nervous. Like, oh my God, I hope I don't make an out. Oh my God, I hope I don't look bad. Oh my God, I hope I don't strike out. Oh my God. No, I'm having fun up here. This is a blast. This is great. Got the Holy Spirit. So the ball's gonna go where the Holy Spirit wants it to go. There is no lack anywhere. Today is my birthday. Now I can give everything to everything. Now I can see everything is given to everything. Now I give everything to everything. And thus there is no lack anywhere. There is no lack anywhere. Now I know. Now I can see. There is no lack anywhere. There is no lack anywhere. And who cares what the pitcher is thinking? The pitcher is thinking, oh, that batter's crazy. Well, it's fine. Now the pitcher's all rattled, you know. The pitcher say, how come that batter's so confident? Wow, he must know what I'm going to throw. See, the pitcher's thinking, well, he must know what I'm going to throw. The pitcher says, well, I better change what I'm going to throw. But he's still confident. Then the pitcher starts thinking, and gets all confused and rattled themselves. And what they do, they float one right over the middle of the plate. So, we have the Holy Spirit. We have the exercise that the Holy Spirit give us. This is gold. This is manna from heaven. The real manna from heaven is the exercise, are the exercises that the Holy Spirit gives us. That's the true manna from heaven. That's what keeps us going in the wilderness. Because we rest upon that. We rest upon that. We don't need anything more. We don't need to know what's coming. Because we know there's no lack anywhere. The Holy Spirit reminds us of truth. So if we're being reminded of truth, and we asserting truth, then we're accepting that truth is true for us. Now, what about others? They seem to be suffering lack. It's because in their imagination, they're trying to make lack real. They're trying to say that truth lacks truth. Okay, in other words, imagination is true. That would mean truth lacks truth. And if truth is imagination, it means truth lacks truth. So they're trying to establish lack as truth. So in trying to do that, simulating it. They're simulating it, believing it can become real. But all lack is just a simulation, a dream simulation. It's not actually there at all. It's not actually true at all. It's a dream simulation. So let the Holy Spirit work with the dream simulation. That's its job. That's not our job. Okay, I want to say this is very important. Working with the dream simulation is not our job. That's the Holy Spirit's job. Our job is to take the spiritual exercises the Holy Spirit gives us and apply those to do that. And then let the Holy Spirit rearrange the simulation, okay, to match the assertions you're making. That's its job. That's what it'll do. Our job is make the assertion of truth. Simply assert that truth is true. That's the only responsibility we have in this dream, is to assert that truth is true. That's it. The Holy Spirit's job is to arrange time and space so that it matches your assertion that truth is true. When you say, I have no lack, there is no lack anywhere, then the Holy Spirit's job is to then manifest that lack of lack, as it were, in your experiencing. That's its job. So don't interfere with this job. Don't say, well, how's this going to happen? No. That's its job. Our job is simply assert that truth is true. That's it. And we do this in various ways. From various angles, because we're so used to imagination thinking there's all sorts of different facets to truth instead of just all sorts of different relationships to truth. Now there's only one relationship, truth with truth. So truth is true and nothing else is true. We simply assert that truth is true. Today is my birthday. Today is my birthday. Now I can give everything to everything. Now I see that everything has everything. Now I give everything to everything. There is no lack anywhere. Thus, there is no lack anywhere. There is no lack anywhere. God's law is applied equally everywhere. Okay, so again, our job is to assert the truth. The Holy Spirit's job is to rearrange time and space, to do the miracles. It's the Holy Spirit that does the miracles, not us. It's the Holy Spirit that does the miracles. We assert the truth. The Holy Spirit is the miracle worker. So we remain poised and simply in assertion of truth, relaxed, poised, with faith in the Holy Spirit. Now, like for instance, in my life, I say, well, it hasn't really happened, hasn't happened. Well, I haven't been doing the practices sufficiently. I've been doing too much thinking about how can I do it, instead of just having, you know, complete faith in the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit will do it, and just asserting that truth is true, truth is true, truth is true. In other words, I'm too much trying to guess how it's going to happen. So that's probably why it hasn't manifested. I have gotten some help, but it did get some help to survive right now, but it's putting me into worse debt. I'll be, you know, in perpetual debt. I'll never be able to get out of it. But at least I'm not sinking. At least I haven't sunk. So there, see, something came. Something happened. So what I need to do is continue to assert the truth and just rely upon my assertion. Only rely just on my assertion and not give any thought for how it's going to happen. That's the Holy Spirit's job. And trust that when I do my job, the Holy Spirit will do its job. And this is a tremendous experiment here, because I am really in very, very, very bad situation. It seems impossible. It really does. It seems impossible. But I know it's not. For the Holy Spirit, it's not impossible. For me, I said it's impossible. I can't get out of this. And the ego says, well, why don't you just kill yourself then if it's impossible? I say, let's see what the Holy Spirit will do. Let's see what the Holy Spirit will do. And the ego says, it's never done anything. I say, well, maybe I need to just let it do its job. Let me do my job. It'll let it do its job. So I'm just going to focus on these spiritual practices, because it's an experiment here. And let's see what happens to my life. Because right now, it's like I'm teetering over the abyss, actually. But I'm staying relaxed and confident and calm, so people might think, oh, there's nothing wrong with him. Look at him, he's relaxed. He said, oh, I know I'm going to succeed. But the actual situation is that there is, I am teetering on the abyss, but I'm trusting in the Holy Spirit. I'm saying, I'm going to assert the truth is true. Today, I'm truly born. Today is my birthday. Now I can give everything to everything. Now I can give everything to everything. Now I see that everything has everything. Now I give everything to everything. There is no lack anywhere. There is no lack anywhere. God's law applies equally to everything, everywhere. We are all under God's one law, always. Everything has everything. There is no lack anywhere. Truth is true. Just assert it. And then don't worry. And whenever there's worry, go right back to the practice again. What do I got to lose? Nothing else is working, so what I got to lose, okay? All right. I agree. Give it a try. That's it.